السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، صلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا ثم ما بعد. So where's the position, where's the side should be in salah? When you're making your salah, what should be looking at? Is it the imam, the qibla? Where exactly do you look? Position of sujood, right? Okay, is that in every position in salah? How about in your sujood, what do you look? Nowhere, right? So basically, it's difficult even to concentrate. But how about when you come back from your ruku'? When you come back from ruku', saying "Sami Allahu liman hamida," and say "Rabbana lak alhamd," where would you look? Would you still look down in the sujood position? You look up because you're making du'a right now. Where exactly would you look? The answer is in this hadith. Now, Imam al-Nawawi rahimahullah ta'ala says over here, "Qala bab an-nahy 'an raf' al-basar ila as-sama' fi as-salah." He says this is a chapter on the prohibition of raising one's eyesight towards the sky during salah, which means you're not allowed to look up during salah, your salah. And usually people sometimes they do that. So when they come back from the ruku' and they say "Sami Allahu liman hamida," they go like this: "Rabbana lak alhamd." Some people they do like this: "Rabbana lak alhamd." Why? Because they know that they're making du'a. Oh Allah, you're deserving of all praise. You're all deserving of all gratitude and thanks. So they make this and they raise their hand like this and they say "Sami Allahu liman hamida, Rabbana lak alhamd." And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in this hadith is actually forbidding us from doing that. Anas radiyallahu ta'ala qala Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam ma balu aqwamin yarfa'una absarahum ila as-sama' ma balu aqwamin yarfa'una absarahum ila as-sama' fi salatihim fashtadda qawluhu fi dhalika hatta qala la yantahiyanna 'an dhalika aw la tukhtafunna absarahum. Rawahu al-Bukhari. In this hadith, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, how is it that some people raise their eyesight towards the sky during salah, you know, their eyes towards the sky, towards salah, and then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he kept stressing this point out so much so that then he said sallallahu alaihi wasallam, people must refrain from raising their eyes towards the heavens in salah, or else their sights will be certainly be snatched away, taken away from them. It's to that level it is considered dangerous. Now, why? The ulama, of course, you know, they give their own interpretation. The Prophet ﷺ did not give exactly the reason why it's prohibited to look up while you're making your salah. But the very common, actually, understanding of it is because it's a distraction. So you always keep in your sujood position. That's number one. Number two, some of the ulama, they say it's kind of disrespectful. If salah is about showing your humbleness, your humility to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when you ask, you know, have you ever seen kids when they ask, in a state of humility and humbleness, what do? They keep looking down. They try to raise their eyes up to see, you know, if you're listening. I mean, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you don't want to test Allah azza wa jal. Allah is there all the time and He listens to you. So when you say "Sami Allahu liman hamida, Rabbana lak alhamd," there is no need for you to kind of try to raise your sight and your eyes to see, "Ya Allah, do you see me?" Allah sees you. Allah hears you subhanahu wa ta'ala. He doesn't need any extra instruction from you. You know, look at me. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hears all, you know, all du'a and all things. And so it's an interpretation from the ulama. And again, it's because it might be distraction, might be kind of against humility and humbleness that would be in salah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you shouldn't be doing that. It seems that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he saw that this became a habit. Some people, they start doing this and it became habit. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made it very clear that these people, they rather stop doing that. Otherwise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take their sight away from them, snatch their sight away from them. So if you ever make your salah, remember that you always keep your eyesight at the position of your sujood. That's again, it's more worthy. It's more actually kind of a sign of humility and humbleness than try to raising your sight up. Ramadan is coming very soon, and you will see people coming with lots and lots of habits, not necessarily from the actual practice of the salah. So if you see anyone does anything wrong, politely and the nicest way possible, you instruct them by letting them know that, you know what, I saw you doing that. We heard from the sheikh in the masjid that the Prophet ﷺ said so and so. Maybe you should check with the sheikh, inshallah ta'ala. so that they don't feel offended by that, they don't feel that someone is targeting them personally. So at least in the nicest way, inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. And all what we do is just deliver the knowledge. We're not responsible to guide the people. We just deliver the knowledge, and people should make the decision to follow or not. Wallahu ta'ala alam. Any question? Yes.
So you stand up straight.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Do you have to lower your neck, exaggerate down?
Before you go, while in standing position?
Yes.
Okay.
Some people just, hunch over and exaggerate down.
Okay. So when you stand in salah, do you have to exaggerate that sense of humility and humbleness, and you hunch over and you just kind of bend your neck down like this? No, you don't have to. You do not have to. I mean, you don't have to have your chin all the way down on your chest. But some people might get emotional in salah, they start crying. So in this case, they will control themselves by maybe looking a little bit further down until their chin hits their chest, actually. But the position of the salah is your face is in a normal position, but your eyes go down on this position of sujood. Wallahu a'lam. Yes?
What about when you look straight?
In salah?
Yeah.
Where?
I mean, I don't know if...
There is no looking straight in salah unless you're in a state of... a special case, such as Salatul Khawf. When you're in Salatul Khawf, Salah that is done during dangers, that time of danger, or during wartime basically, then in this case, the Musallin are actually warriors. So therefore, when they pray, they don't look down in the position of sujood. No, they keep guard. So that as they make a Salah, they're still actually guarding the situation around them. That's the only position I would say you would be looking forward. And I remember actually one time when we were in Bosnia, in a city up north in the country, they opened a new big center. Was sponsored by some, mashallah, wealthy people from the Gulf. So when they brought a prominent sheikh for the opening ceremony of the masjid, which has also an Islamic school with it and so on. So as we were coming in, we came to the main musalla area to find out that, mashallah, it's a fancy place. Beautiful, beautiful musalla. The entire front wall of the masjid, minus the mihrab area, was made into glass. The entire, not just windows, no, the entire wall was made into thick glass. And it's overlooking, of course, a garden outside, hadiqa, and outside the masalla. So eventually the sheikh kind of looked at that and he just goes, what is this for? So the philosophy of the people, they said, well, when people start their salah, we want them to look through the window so they can remember al-jannah, inshallah ta'ala. So they would have more khushu'ah, yani. Of course, this is not acceptable. Yani, I hope that they had maybe brought some blinds, perhaps, or some curtains to cover that. But some people, subhanAllah, out of good intentions, they make the wrong things. Allahumma musta'an.
Nah. What about closing your eyes?
Closing your eyes. What about closing your eyes in salah? Should you close your eyes? Can you close your eyes in salah? The answer, first of all, you should not be closing your eyes in salah. Unless you are in a situation that is you cannot concentrate at all. Imam Ahmad rahimahullah ta'ala actually said that if the case comes to khushu' versus closing the eyes, opening the eyes, in this case, close your eyes because the khushu' is a wajib more than just keep your eyes open. Wallahu a'lam. However, you need to train yourself not to be distracted by whatever is around you. Make sure that you train yourself to be focused on your salah. I know it's hard and difficult, but as much as you can. Now, yes.
So what about when you make dua in witr or whatever?
You still look down? Even when you make dua during witr and so on, you don't look up, raising your hands like this, instead you keep looking down. Wallahu a'lam. Yes.
Some brothers are like, they have habit of looking like when people...
All around?
People walking, especially in our musalla.
MashaAllah.
They look eye to eye, like, who's, and they're in the salah.
Like some brothers, mashallah, on their salah, they keep looking at the window to see who's coming in and who's out. And sometimes, you know, they look at you eye to eye, like saying, salamu alaykum, alaykum salam, right? This is salat. Maybe they're guarding the doors, yaakhi. That's why, zamallah khair, good job, mashallah. No, it's not your responsibility to guard the door, jazakumullah khair. So when you make your salah, keep looking down in the position of sujood. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from you, jama'ah. Jazakumullah khair. Subhanakallah wa bihamdika. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.